good sportsmanship goes beyond the court. It starts with respect. Respect the game. The Orlando Magic are proud to support this season of middle school basketball. For more information on Orlando Magic Youth Initiatives, visit OrlandoMagicYouth.com.
We're often asked, what's more important in retirement, having a great plan or working with a great advisor? The answer is that both are vitally important to your retirement success. Retirement planning is not just a one and done. Even the best plans will need to be adjusted. That's exactly why you need an experienced partner to guide you on your journey. How confident are you? Call us today for a second opinion.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome into the Varsity Sports Network right here on this gorgeous Friday evening in mid-May as we're on game two or night two of the 2022 spring football season right here on your home for high school sports in Florida, the Varsity Sports Network. I'm Bobby Allen. Appreciate you tuning in. Joined tonight by Bobby Latmore, and also you'll hear from Madison Little here in just a little bit, our sideline reporter. But Bobby had a great start last night with two games that we had on VSN for the start of the 2022 spring season. It just feels like fall, man. It's great seeing the kids out on the field, everybody into football.
You know, it's funny you mentioned that because we were thinking this morning when we woke up, holy cow, it's Saturday.
Yeah.
We just did two football games last night. What a great night we had there on Varsity Sports Network. Two great games, as you mentioned, Bobby, and it just absolutely kicked off the spring in perfect succession tonight. We got so much more going on here for spring football here on the Varsity Sports Network, and man, I tell you what, we got a good one here tonight.
We really do. We are here coming to you live from Titusville Astronaut High School as the Windermere Wolverines come visiting here in this spring game. Windermere, we'll talk about them first. Last season they went 2-8. They are in 8A Division 9, and they have a brand new head coach, Ricky Smith. He spent the last 16 seasons at Dr. Phillips, and so if anybody knows how to win,
yeah,
and those have put together a program.
Without a doubt,
it's Ricky Smith.
Absolutely, he's come. You know, he's done very well there from where he's been before. So we're looking forward to see what he has going on tonight. Spring, a time that you're going to look forward to see what you've got working going into the summer, and then also getting ready for the fall. So we'll go with that and see what's happening down there on the field.
Yeah, let's do it. Let's take you now down field side with our own Madison Little.
Bobby, I had the opportunity to talk to coaches from both sides before the game tonight about what they're hoping to accomplish. Windermere told me they're hoping to execute on offense, get physical on defense, and simply have fun. But on the other hand, the War Eagles are narrowing down who can and who can't tonight. That's their goal. Now back to you guys in the booth.
Thank you so much, Madison. We appreciate all her hard work down at field side as we just had the coin toss. And real quick, we'll talk about Titusville Astronaut. They are under head coach Justin Warden. They went 3-6 last season in Class 4A. They lost two key players, Larry Lee, and Antonio Cato. Big-time players for this Astronaut team. Stat leaders across the board on both sides of the football. So they're going to be looking at a couple of guys to fill that position. And some of the players to watch, a primary running back, Hunter Zarm. Also at quarterback tonight, number 22, Ryan Gordon for Astronaut. And wide receiver, Nathan Perrin, a few names to note. Titusville Astronaut said they like to run first offense, but they'll throw it out of play action. Tonight's game brought to you by State Farm. It is Craig Martin, Insurance and Financial Services. We appreciate him sponsoring our high school football along with Gators Docksides in Central Florida. We appreciate everybody who comes out to Gators, and we appreciate Gators for putting VSN live in their restaurants. And everybody tuning in Windermere tonight, appreciate it. It's excellent.
Absolutely. Good watch party going over there at the Gators Dockside in Windermere tonight. Appreciate y'all tuning in and watching it tonight. Your Wolverines about ready to get this one on. See what you guys got for the fall and looking forward to the 2022 season. So heads up, Wolverines, here we go.
Windermere will start with the football after winning the toss. Isaiah Nell will be back deep to receive. The Wolverines will put three back, standing at about the 10-yard line. And for Astronaut, it will be Ryan Gordon wearing number 22, the junior, to kick it away and get this game underway. Again, a beautiful Friday night here in Titusville. It's going to be fielded right in the center, and whistles blow. That was fielded by Lee Polk. He will also do some field duties, or return duties, for the Windermere Wolverines. Every time I see Windermere's uniforms, it looks like the Seattle
the
Seahawks.
Seattle Seahawks. That's
I
exactly right.
That.
Yep. Where's what's the quarterback, Russell Martin? Yep. I mean, he's gone now. He's not there.
Russell
he's
Wilson.
Denver.
Yep.
Russell Wilson. Yeah, he's now over Denver. But yeah, these guys look just like the Seahawks coming out. Man, they got beautiful uniforms here tonight. I'll
they
tell
really
you
do. And I like Titusville's too. Easy to see that that maroon on with white numerals and lettering looks clean. So first and 10. Here for Windermere. It'll be Bryce Speed under center. What a name for a football player. He's going to hand it off. Coming to the near side with room to run is Andre Ochoa. He's the primary back for Windermere, and he gets it across the 30 up to about the 33-yard line.
Yeah, we saw Ochoa a couple times last year in a couple games we did for Windermere, and he had fantastic games. So it's a name to watch coming up here in 2022 here for the Wolverines.
Again, talking to Coach Ricky Smith. Prior to the game, he was all smiles, man. He was so excited about taking over this program at Windermere and building a program with it. He was very excited about the kids who had bought in, the communities rallied around him, and I think the future is going to look bright. This is just the fourth season for this Windermere High School program. This school was built to alleviate some pressure over on the in Windermere west side of town. Here's another handoff right up through the middle. Goes Ochoa across the 45 into War Eagle territory. Or no, just shy of War Eagle territory to the 49.
So the War Eagles. Nice run right there. Big time for Ochoa. Again, they're going to be the premier back, so we're going to see exactly how much they're going to use him tonight.
Yeah, Titusville Astronaut has seen a healthy dose of Andres Ochoa already here with just a minute gone by in this first quarter.
And, of course, spring, everybody's kind of getting their offense down and everything, so they're kind of looking over towards getting their signs to the sideline right now.
Sure.
So a learning experience for everybody here in the fall and the spring here for all these teams.
Trips to the high side of the field, single receiver to the near side. Here's Speed, hands off to Ochoa, breaks a tackle, good move, gets to the line of scrimmage. Lucky to get away from that first contact. He's a shifty running back.
Yeah,
good
he
on
is.
His legs.
Yes, he is. And I'll tell you what, he's going to be fun to watch, and we'll just see how many highlights we get from him tonight.
Absolutely. And something else to note, that Windermere returned quite a few players that got a lot of experience the last two seasons, particularly on the offensive and defensive line. So that right there is something, obviously, that you can take and build from that.
Absolutely. So we'll see how they progress throughout the night. And, you know, this is a stepping stone into the summer. So
sure.
A lot of things right now that the coaches are looking at, what's their strengths and also their weaknesses here going into the summer, getting ready for the fall.
Trips in a bunch on the near side. Here's a quick hitter. Top of the screen. Catch made, a beautiful move. That catch is from Jonathan Porter, and he's able to make his way up near the 40. He's going to be stopped just shy at about the 42-yard line. What a move to get away from that would-be tackler.
Nice swing pass out to the receiver to the far side over there. One-on-one situation. Was able to make a nice stiff arm, get around to the outside, and pick up about a good 9 yards. It's going to be second down and one coming up, or third down and one, I should say.
It's beautiful when you have a guy out there on the edge like Porter, who stands about 6'4".
Yes.
Great target.
No doubt.
Athletic as he can be. He's going to line up on the near side this time. They'll send three receivers top of the screen. Ochoa in the backfield. Speed in the gun. He has a little trouble with the snap. He's able to fall on it.
Tough break right there for Windermere. Just a bad snap, but he's able to fall on it. Yep. No turnover right there. Moves him back about another 7 yards. So a big fourth down now and seven comes up. Let's see what they decide to do.
He was fortunate right there to get that football back. And that gives Astronaut a break. A little bit of a breathing
Absolutely.
Situation on defense.
They got... let's see, fourth, though. They gave him a yard or two, so it looks like fourth and six coming up here. But, yeah, I mean, Astronaut definitely, you know, you'd rather face a fourth and 6 in the third and 1.
Absolutely. This time, snap is clean. Speed rolls to the near side. Catch is made, and it's going to depend on the spot. Catch was made by Chris Maurice on fourth down, and no indication yet as to whether they're going to give him the first down.
Yeah, I think they are. He got it off, so I think they did give him the first down, and they're going to put it right in place. They're going to kind of bring him the chains out. I thought he had a good spot.
I did too.
I thought he had enough for the first down, but I guess the referee saw where he got swung back around and did not pick up the first down. So we'll just see how they do when they come out here for the measurement coming up here with the referees. Referees tonight, you know, from the A1's Referee Association, and we had a great week of referees. Bobby, you were at the Boone High School last weekend and talked about the referees and their little get-together they had over there to kind of recruit some.
An excellent organized event by our very own Adam Bates. It was a 2022 recruiting fair at Boone High School, and they had about 75 to 80 pre-registered. By the time it was all said and done, about 100 registered. To try to entice people to get into officiating. There's an official shortage, and that is enough for the first down. Good call, Bobby Latimore, on that one. That'll give Windermere first and 10 at the Astronaut 42, but it was a great turnout, and I think that could be something that could catch on, because it's not just Florida. It's nationally. There's somewhat of a crisis that, you know, is potentially on the horizon with the, you know, obviously you don't have officials, you don't have sport.
Exactly.
So that's really something important. I think they did a wonderful job, I want to point this out, of convincing those in attendance that it's not just about being on the field. It's about getting paid. You can make a career out of it. It's very easy to take that and make something of a career out of officiating. So I thought that was a great evening at Boone High School.
Yep, no doubt. First and 10 now here for the Wolverines.
Ochoa right up the gut. Good job by Astronaut there defensively. Evan Callahan in there on the tackle for the War Eagles.
Evan Callahan.
That'll bring up second and about six as Windermere gets inside the 40.
After this quarter,
we've seen a solid showing here early by Andres Ochoa and a couple of good throws from Bryce Speed. They like to mix it up a little bit. They've thrown several different formations at Astronaut here. This time they're going to have one wide receiver each way. Ochoa in the backfield. Speed has another mishandle on the snap, able to pick it up and get rid of it, but that's going to fall incomplete. And that 2 or 3 second, that half second really made the difference between a completion and an incomplete pass.
You're working on something right now, probably a new center here for the Wolverines. The quarterback exchange is the most important start of the whole play. Obviously, if it doesn't happen, it doesn't go. So right now, they're trying to get everything in to rhythm here, and just a couple bad snaps just to get things going. And you know what? That's his thing where the centers, too, he's also making calls on the blind. He's trying to get those blocking situations all set up and figure that out. While he's doing that, he's also got a snap. So a lot going on for the center right now, and it's probably a new one here for the Wolverines this year, so he's learning a lot as well.
Absolutely. New center and new quarterback. Yep. Here's Speed again. This time he collects it, fires across the middle. Great defense.
Nice defense.
That is Jordan Marquez, the sophomore, coming up with a big play for Titusville Astronaut. And by the way, this is a beautiful facility. You and I talked about it before the game. It's a absolutely stunning natural grass surface here at Astronaut High School. They've been very welcoming, and we're very happy to be here. The little coast football action over here,
right
near Cape Canaveral.
Yeah, we were asking when we came over here, you know, are they going to launch a rocket tonight?
Wouldn't that be neat?
We had the perfect seat for it, especially with almost a full moon right here, man. It's right, Cape Canaveral, right just about, what, 20 miles, 25 miles from us.
Maybe so, and I think you're about right, and they're supposed to launch one tomorrow at 4:30. We'll see.
We got to come back.
I know, right? Bryce Speed, he's going to tuck it and run, tries to get the right edge, does, beats one tackler, and then gets lit up, but has enough. I think,
way short.
He's going to gain about 2 yards. I saw the contact, and boy, he got lit up on the turn there as he got near the 40. Credit the effort, though, from Bryce Speed. So, Windermere goes four and out. And now Titusville Astronaut will take over at their own 36-yard line. And we will see Ryan Gordon in at quarterback. Ryan Gordon, a junior, plays a little defensive back and also might see him at wide receiver. Here's a running play right up the middle. That's going to be to Hunter Zarm. Zarm, a freshman on this Astronaut squad. They're looking for big things out of him, especially considering he is a youngster and getting the nod at starting running back here. Also keep an eye on number one, Nigel Barkin, and number three, Lewis Johnson, also playmakers, and 80, Nathaniel Perrin. Those guys are athletes. They'll do a little bit of anything. Here's Gordon. Hand off the backfield to Zarm. He's going to be hit as he crosses the line of scrimmage and pushed back. Great defense in the interior by Windermere. Maurice. Chris Maurice in on the stop for Windermere. It'll be third and about seven. Gordon's going to have two receivers set up on the near side. Single man to the backfield here on third down. Handoff is going to go to Nigel Barkin, and he's going to be hit immediately and pushed back for a loss. So the Windermere defensive front has done their job and created a third and about 12 here for Titusville Astronaut. Give that front three or four credit for what they've done here on this first offensive possession for Titusville Astronaut. Astronaut's going to have to kick it away. War Eagles, nothing doing there on that first possession.
Yep, just nice job there by Windermere, just setting up their defense and making things happen.
Windermere is going to send three deep here on this punt attempt. Punts, with this being a spring game, are not live. So the ball is going to be fielded on the near side. It'll be collected by Isaiah Nell. And that is where Windermere will have it. First and 10 on what will be their second possession of the contest here this evening. First possession, four and out for Windermere. And three and out for Titusville Astronaut, thanks to that pressure. I mean, starting with the first play from scrimmage for Windermere to put pressure on Astronaut. And here we have a penalty and a false start against Astronaut will be declined. So it will stay Windermere football. And looks like they're going to give him a water break. Windermere's taking the field again. Astronaut still over on the sideline.
And they are.
Yep,
they're going to take a water break.
We'll take a break. Back in a moment. Right here on the Varsity Sports Network.
Retirement income plans. Many of our clients are extremely concerned with increasing federal debt and that taxes could go up significantly. Call today for your no obligation complimentary consultation. We have the specific tools to help you develop your own tax efficient retirement income plan.
And welcome back into the Varsity Sports Network here from Titusville Astronaut High School. I'm Bobby Allen along with Bobby Latmore. And we have Madison Little down on the field for our sideline reporting this beautiful Friday evening here over on the coast as we have a spring game. The third game that we've covered here this spring season on the Varsity Sports Network. Two games last night featuring Masters Academy and First Academy.
It looks like we already got a penalty here.
Sure do.
Offsides against Astronaut. So it's going to set
quick
up now first down and five to go here. Start things off. So Windermere with a little bit of a break. All, you know, it's been mostly on middle of the field tonight. So yep. No really field advantage at all either from either team.
That's true. Here's Speed in at quarterback. Hands off.
big hole.
It'll be a huge hole for Ochoa, and he has already had a heck of a first quarter. He gets the ball all the way down to just shy of the 40-yard line for Windermere, and that'll be first and 10 for the Wolverines. Yeah, Timber Creek, Lake Nona also last night here on the Varsity Sports Network. That game ended 41-21 in favor of Timber Creek, and First Academy 35-21 over Masters Academy. Great turnouts for all these games, too.
Yes.
I think it's just the power of football in Florida. First and 10 for Bryce Speed. Trips to the near side. Single receiver top of the screen. Single man in the backfield. Ochoa is going to come in motion. Get the handoff. Great read defensively.
Nice job defensively. Good
Wonderful.
Penetration.
That was outstanding for Titusville Astronauts. Number 56, Vondre Washington. He and number 99, Langston Edmonds. Two players to watch on that defensive front for the War Eagles. That time, Vondre Washington able to beat Ochoa. Met him just after getting the handoff from Speed. Second and about 14. Here's Speed, drops back out of the shotgun, rolls to his right, fires it as the pressure comes, has a man, he's coming back for the football, and it's going to be tipped at the last moment. No flags.
No
incomplete.
Flags. Kind of a little bit of contact there right
was.
Before while the ball was in the air. Referee didn't think that was too much, but yeah, there was a lot of contact right there. So interesting call by the ref not to give him the interference, but still remains third down.
Really was interesting as the intended target came back for the football. It was underthrown just a little bit. He made contact with the Titusville defensive backs. Here we go, third and about 13, 14 yards. Once again, Bryce Speed's going to line up in the shotgun. In the backfield, it'll be Andres Ochoa. Trips to the near side, single receiver top of the screen. Same formation as they had on the last play. Pressure comes again. This time he dumps it off over the top to Ochoa. Makes the catch. Gets about 3-4 yards. And it'll be fourth and about 11 here for the Wolverines of Windermere.
Yeah, they nice tried to set up the screen in the middle to Ochoa, but Astronaut with a very nice read on it. The lineman went down the field, but Astronaut kind of read the release, and they stayed home and did a nice job of corralling Ochoa right there at the line of scrimmage.
You got to give that defensive front for Astronaut credit. They have found their way into the backfield of Windermere on the last two possessions.
Good look at that Windermere offense breaking out of the huddle right there. Just a nice job of just getting here to the spring. Just, you know, it's football. I just love it. We're back at it.
It's awesome. Fourth and 11, Speed in the gun. Ochoa in the backfield. Speed's going to keep it. Tries the right side. Has the edge. Thinks about a throw, has the first down, and is pushed out of bounds, shy of the 35-yard line, so Windermere will move the chains.
Nope, that's still a little short, Bobby.
Oh, they're looking at the wrong one. I'm crazy.
There's two of them out there. See, Bobby?
The guy that's...
See the first orange one, and then you have the second orange one out there?
The one on the left, the guy keeps throwing down, and I'm just... Yeah.
That is true. Every time the play comes even close,
he throws it.
Throwing it down.
It's the only one I see. So scratch that. First and 10 for Titusville. Penalty is going to be declined. That was a run play from the get-go. Speed got the snap, immediately took off to his right. Now, we will see Titusville Astronaut again after a second, fourth and out. Turnover on downs for Windermere. They've tried it on fourth down twice so far in this contest. To no avail thus far, Titusville will take over at their own 36-yard line.
And, folks, we do apologize about the clock. The clock's been kind of acting up a little bit on us. It starts when it wants to, and it doesn't when it doesn't. So just bear with us tonight. We'll kind of even up and let you know where we are with the time. But clock's going to be kept mostly on the field.
2:40 officially in the game here in the first period. Two receivers to the near sides. Single man in the backfield. It's going to be handed off to Zarm, and he slices his way across the 40 out to about the 42, maybe the 43-yard line.
Nice cut right there off the right side of that offensive line for Astronaut. doing a nice job by sealing the inside, and the running back able to make the corner.
His arm's shifty.
Yep.
Seen him make some quick cuts on that last possession for Titusville Astronaut. What's a luxury when you can quickly go into a second and very manageable four. Ben Brown with a little motion there. Hand off again to Zarm, this time at the near side. Gets across midfield. Spun to the ground, but he does get into Wolverine territory, and that'll be first and 10. And Astronaut will move the chains. War Eagles on the move here in their second possession of the contest.
Basically the same play. They went right after it. Just run it till you stop me.
Yeah, I mean, they like what they see up front, especially you can tell in those last two plays. It was, you know, he was at the second level before real contact occurred. See if they can keep that going. They're going to line up two receivers near side yet again. Ryan Gordon stands in the shotgun. Two men in the backfield with him. Jordan Marquez, a little bit of motion there. Hand off to Harm again. Slips a tackle. Gets across the 40 down to the 39-yard line as a helmet comes off and a flag goes flying.
This is going to be helmet-to-helmet right here. This is going to be pretty big, substantial penalty right here, because right when he was spinning, coming down, a young man from the back of the Windermere defense came in and put his helmet right on the back of number four there for Astronaut, and he just took his helmet right off. So that'll be a little bit of a targeting call here on Windermere.
Zarm, appears to be fine. He's over on the sideline getting a drink of water. Tough kid.
Yeah, very tough.
Impressive. So it is going to be a personal foul against the Wolverines, and that will give Astronaut another first down, and that will put them much deeper into Wolverine territory in a no-score contest with a minute 19 to play in the first quarter.
Yep.
Line of scrimmage is going to be the 25.
Yep, big job, right? Big penalty right there. Moves Astronaut in really good field position inside the 25, right at the 25 right now. So let's see what they can do with it. Take advantage of a situation where Windermere made a mistake.
Astronaut with two men lined up on the near side. That'll be Ashton Alberts and Lewis Johnson. Marquez in motion. Gordon gets the handoff, and nothing happening there on that run play as Windermere met that play right at the point of attack. Nigel Barkin able to get that going.
Yeah, they kind of sold out Windermere defense on that play right there, Bobby, and they came with the full house, and they corralled the running back in the backfield for a couple-yard loss. And I'll tell you what, that right there doesn't hurt, but still, now you got to do something different with your offense.
And just to give you an idea about this Windermere program, you know, there's nowhere to go but up for them.
Right.
Their first season, they went 0-10 three seasons ago, then 2-8, 3-7, and then 2-8 last year. And then brought in Ricky Smith from Dr. Phillips this year. And he's really anxious to see what he can do with this Wolverine program. Here's a handoff to Harm. Goes left, and he's met at the edge.
Nice
edge.
Job defensively, wow. Bobby, on that Windermere far side over there. Stayed at home. Turned the play back in, and look who was there, his buddies, and all three of them corralled the running back, and he had nowhere to go that time.
Absolutely. Numbers can be deceiving sometimes. We hope all the numbers are right with these spring games. They just kind of hand out jerseys on the day of. So I have that as Remy Kottman with the tackle for Windermere. Great.
Close enough.
Playing the ball. Yeah, it works.
If it wasn't Remy, you got your name called tonight.
Yes, sir. And now we're going to have whistles and a timeout. We'll take a break with them. No score here from Titusville Astronaut as visiting Windermere comes to town. We'll be back right here on the Varsity Sports Network.
One shot, not a future for sure. Let's go. Yeah, I was building on the lecture. Verses coming daily under pressure. Working on the plot and the scheme. The true style trademark is at the edge of your dreams. I'm talking one. One shot for the kill, the priest.
Yes, sir!
I'm turning dreams into reality. In the lab with the formula and chemistry. Your memories spark and motivate and make the industry shake. We put the balls in the brakes. I'm talking one. One chance at best, yes. Painting pictures for the culture, keep the brushes fresh. Flip the flower, work the drummer, passion never rests. Freedom is our teacher, under pressure, now we bless. See, I was told, boys, what we go. It's one art, one shot, not a future, but yours. Go! Yeah. It's one art, one shot, not a future, but yours. Go!
Yeah, we'll get back into the Varsity Sports Network here from Titusville Astronaut as we have concluded the first quarter of play, no score. I'm Bobby Allen along with Bobby Latmore. Let's go down to the field side now with our own Madison Little.
Guys, I want to give a huge shout out to all our Wolverines fans and anyone joining us over at Gators Dockside in Windermere tonight. I'm having so much fun out here enjoying some high school football for the first time in what feels like forever, and I hope you are too. So again, huge thank you to you guys and to Gators Dockside over in Windermere for joining us on Varsity Sports Network tonight. Back to you guys.
Thanks so much, Madison Little. No score, just underway here, second quarter from Titusville Astronaut High School as the Wolverines of Windermere have come visiting. And it's going to be fourth down and about 15 here for Astronaut as Gordon will be in the shotgun. Zarm in the backfield. They'll send, let's see, Lewis Johnson and Ashton Alberts wide to the top of your screen.
Big play right here for both of these teams right now. Even though it's early in the game, spring and stuff like that, just how do you respond to a fourth and 15 deep in your opponent's territory right here, as well as Windermere? You got your backs up against the wall right now.
Here's Gordon, rolls to the right. Pressure comes, escapes, ball comes out, and it's going to be pounced on. I think it looked like it was picked up by Astronaut, but
doesn't
Windermere
matter.
Is celebrating,
right,
and it's fourth.
Yeah,
so that's going to be another four and out.
Yep. That
Windermere takes over.
Didn't matter if they recovered it or not. It's turnover on downs right there for Windermere. Great job defensively. They had a little bit of a mistake right there with a personal foul penalty. Allowed Astronaut deep in their territory, but they stood up, built a wall, and moved them backwards, actually, Bobby, from their original line of scrimmage from
they
the
really
penalty.
Did. So Windermere will take over on their own 27-yard line, and that is the farthest we've seen either one of these teams into the opponent's territory so far here in this game. So give credit to Windermere moving the football. They got helped down by a couple of penalties, but they did put some things together thanks to the running of Zarm. So now we'll see Windermere come out on offense for what is going to be their third possession of the contest. They're going to send Lee Polk to the near side, lined up as wide receiver. Bryce Speed in at quarterback. He's going to go under center this time. Ochoa in the backfield. Here comes a man in motion, and it will be a handoff coming right at you, cutting back upfield across the 30. Flag comes in after a gain of about 3. And that penalty is going to be against Windermere.
Yeah, the little bit of holding in the backfield back there on the backside, and I think the referee back judge saw that and is going to move him back a little bit.
There was no hesitation on throwing that flag either. They were right on top of it. That was too obvious. If you're going to do it,
yep,
be sneaky.
Exactly.
11:42 left here in the first half of play. Again, this game brought to you by Craig Martin Insurance and Financial Services by State Farm. We appreciate his support of high school academics and athletics, and also Gators Dockside in Central Florida. All those folks watching live at Gators Dockside over in Windermere, we appreciate you. Here are the Wolverines. They'll have trips to the near side. Single receiver top of the screen. Bryce Speed in the shotgun. Ochoa in the backfield. High snap. Speed corrals it. Fires it to the far side. Catch is made by Porter. He's going to be wrapped up and dropped. Good defense on the outside by Astronaut High. War Eagles defended that very well.
Porter with, you mentioned him, 6'4", yeah, wide receiver out there, able to go up and get that one pretty far up there. Good job defensively for Astronaut to corral him. No gain on the play right there. It's going to set up now second down.
And a good job by Bryce B, too. That snap was high.
Yeah, it was.
We talked about that.
Yep.
New quarterback, new center. That takes a minute. And we're early, folks. You know, you got to think this is, they've had very, very few practice minutes here. Here's Speed again, trips to the near side.
Weren't we over there? We did a baseball game over there. They just started the spring practices over there that day.
That's it. Here's Speed rolling to the near side, trying to fire it downfield, looking for Rosier. And it's going to fall incomplete. Going to be on the pronunciation. I don't know if it's Rosier or Rosier.
We'll go with Rozier.
Okay,
you called that first.
Yeah.
And then, you know, with the pass right there on the rollout, that was interesting to see right there, Bobby, because he had a lot of room in front of him and
really just
decided to throw it deep. If he kept the ball, and he might have made that corner and got a little bit more yardage. But now a big third down now coming up.
Third and a mile here with 10:30 to play in the first half. Coach Hayes last night with the broadcast with us.
Yep.
And he was getting antsy. He wanted to see some vertical action. He was torn up that they weren't throwing downfield. Here's a handoff straight ahead to Ochoa and a great
defense right there. Nice job defensively by the middle linebacker right there for Astronaut.
Listen, we've called his name a couple of times. That's number six, Jordan Marquez.
Yes, Marquez, great job staying home right there and was able to catch that one. I mean, just absolutely knocked.
Yep. He's come to play.
Yes, he did. Windermere nowhere to go now, fourth down.
Just a sophomore is Jordan Marquez. There are no seniors out tonight for this game. There are seven rising seniors. So a very
young
astronaut.
That's a good point. This is all young football.
Team.
This is everything coming up for astronaut
right
here. That's a really, really good point.
9:45, clock rolls. On the punt attempt here by Windermere after a great stand by astronaut.
Nice punt.
Great punt fielded by Titusville's number 22, Ryan Gordon. And the War Eagles will have the football first and 10 at their own 45, so they'll start this drive with really good field position, their best field position of the contest. So you really got to give credit to after that initial drive by Windermere where you saw a heavy dose of Andres Ochoa. Really, Titusville Astronaut did not have an answer at first, but boy, have they made some adjustments, and that's a wonderful sign in a spring game that those adjustments can be made. And their defense has come to play here the last two drives for this War Eagle program.
Yep.
Very impressive.
I love it. Astronaut War Eagle. I wonder if somebody from Auburn came over here and
I don't know.
Named this team.
I mean, you know, I can tell you what I assumed the name would be, but I was clearly wrong.
Right.
Yeah. Here comes Gordon. Hand off to Zarm. Coming to the near side. Crosses the 40.
Oh.
Gets hit. Ball comes out, and it's going to be picked up by Windermere. What a hit and a great recovery. The hands on the pickup by Zachary Friend. And Windermere takes over after the fumble.
Give it up for whoever, number 20 for Windermere, was made the hit. And
Jelani Reams.
Yes, Reams had it beautifully, knocked it down right out of the running back's hands, and number 50 was there to make the play. Great job right there for Windermere's defense.
That was outstanding, and Windermere now takes over first and 10. They'll have it at the 35-yard line. We haven't seen anyone hit Painter yet in this contest. 9:26 to play here in the first half. Stick around for the halftime show. We'll hear from our sideline reporter, Madison Little, and get you ready for the second half. But right now, it's Bryce Speed and the Wolverine offense on the field. Ochoa in the backfield. Two receivers on the top of the screen. He's looking that way. Speed floats one into the flat, and it's going to be incomplete. Good-looking throw. Just his intended target took the eye off the ball for just enough time to fumble it and drop it.
Again, Bobby, you mentioned it earlier. These kids, just first time being out here together, wide receivers and quarterbacks, really haven't found their rhythm yet with each other. That chemistry will come in the summertime when they start working on their 7-and-7s and stuff. So a good start right here for them to get going, because this is contact right here. This isn't 7-on-7 where you don't have contact. You can throw it all you want to in air against air. But this right here lets them understand we got to do something a little different here if we want to make the connections.
Intended target on that play was Octavio Uloa. They call him Tavi Uloa. First time we've got the opportunity to call his name tonight. Two receivers up top, single receiver to the near side. Handoff goes to Ochoa, got a little bit of room, but a good tackle from behind by Lewis Johnson. That was number 9, Damarian Curry.
Yep, Curry and 99.
Sophomore.
Big 99 there as well, so sophomore and the other one.
Believe he's a freshman 99?
Yeah, I can't. Sophomore and a freshman teaming
sophomore
up on that
freshman.
That's a good look there for Astronaut coming up here.
Aren't they?
Yes.
This team's young, and they look good to be that young. So let's see what Windermere has here on third and long. Third and 9 from their own 36. Going to line up single receiver to the near side, trips up top. Ochoa in the backfield. Whistle and a flag comes in from the far side. It's going to be offsides against Astronaut.
Wow, that hurts that right does. There. It sure does. Third and nine, you were had them backed up a little bit right now. They had to throw the ball. Now the playbook opens up a little bit. You can pretty much do anything you want to right here with a good running team. Man, that was not a good move right there for Astronaut.
It was interesting. One of the things Coach Warden said before the game, he wanted to work on defensive penalties. And so far, they had been very clean, and that was a big one there. Here's Bryce Speed rolling to the left, gets upended as he tries to get back to the line of scrimmage. He cannot do it. He's going to be dropped for a loss of two, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Yep. Good play defensively there for Astronaut. Again, they opened up the book a little bit
yep.
where they could go around and try to, you know, with a running play right there, and they gave the run option there to the quarterback, and unfortunately, good for Astronaut because they did a great job defensively.
Man, I can't tell you how impressed I've been with Astronaut's yes. defensive presence. You know, it looks like they've grown up from the beginning of this game to now. It's a totally different defensive unit. Very impressive how quick they've adjusted to Windermere offense.
Oh, mercy. Uh-oh. My boy Adam Bates made a comment on my little war eagle. Of course, he's from Auburn, played at Auburn.
Yep.
Somebody had to go there.
Yeah, Bulldogs and Wildcats, we don't talk about that.
That's right. You're outnumbered out here. But Adam Bates, a great addition here to Varsity
yeah.
Sports Network this year. With his officiating and everything that he's doing is just yeah. phenomenal. We hope we back him 100% for everything he does. So we look forward to more of those great recruiting fairs.
That was awesome.
Yes.
And I know that's not easy to put together. In 3 weeks' time, he organized that. It was just an incredible job, and it's been a pleasure to get to know him, and I really look forward to working with him here in the future. Great asset for the Varsity Sports Network. 7:42 to play first half, no score. Astronauts defense has put their offense in a position to do some good. Here's Zarm on a handoff coming to the near side, gets across midfield before he's hit and dropped. Great gain on first down, gain of six. It'll be second and four. It's two drives in a row, the opening play has resulted in a second and a very manageable three or four, and that's a win every time.
You know, Zarm, same play that he fumbled on the last time right there. So a good job for him holding on to it right there because Windermere came here to hit tonight.
Yeah, they really did. There we go, Gordon in the shotgun again. Two men in the backfield. Two receivers to his right. 6:59 on the clock, first half. Gordon on the keeper this time. He's going to have the first down as he crosses the 45 down to the 44-yard line. Maybe the 43 on the spot. So Astronaut moving the chains here against Windermere.
Good read by Gordon right there. He had the run pass option right there, and he pulled it out of the running back coming the other way on another off-tackle play to the right over there. But he kept it coming back to the left and was wide open, picked up a nice 6 yards, got the first down.
Two men to the backfield again. Gordon in the shotgun. Receivers to the high side of the field. Here's a handoff to Nigel Barkin. He makes his way out across the 40 to the pretty close to the 41. Good gain on first down yet again for Astronaut. So far in this game, they've been an outstanding first down team on offense.
Yes, they have. Good pickup yardage there on first down. And, you know, when you got second and five every time, you get your playbook continually opens up.
Yes. Looks like Ashton Alberts and Nathan Burdett will line up to the high side for Astronaut as Gordon stands in the shotgun. He'll have Nigel Barkin right behind him. Barkin gets the handoff, avoids one tackle across the 40, cuts back into the middle, gets spun up in the air and downed. He has enough for the first down at about the 31-yard line.
So a nice job right there. Great run by Barkin right there. That was a nice job. Looks like we're going to have a water break now. Timeout.
Looks like we are too. Barkin, another sophomore. Team's young. Folks, we're going to take a break. No score. Second quarter. Right here on the Varsity Sports Network.
Timeout on the field. This will be good time.
This championship goes beyond the court. It starts with respect. Respect the game. The Orlando Magic are proud to support this season of middle school basketball. For more information on Orlando Magic youth initiatives, visit OrlandoMagicYouth.com.
And welcome back into the Varsity Sports Network here from Astronaut High School in Titusville, Florida. I'm Bobby Allen along with Bobby Latmore as the Wolverines of Windermere come calling here in this spring game on this gorgeous Friday night.
It is here on the coast. Isn't it? It's Friday night. Come on, man. Is it the fall? Let's go. Let's play. Let's get to the fall.
Let's do it. Here's a handoff to Barkin for Astronaut. He's going to be drugged down by a host of Wolverines behind the line of scrimmage.
Great defense right there by Windermere. They saw the play coming. They kind of read it right off the bat. And we'll go back and talk a little bit about this, but, you know, that's a loss of 10 on that right there, almost 12.
That'll make the line of scrimmage the 35-yard line. We will see Gordon look to the sideline for
the call. I've got third down. The yard marker over there has second, but we're going to go with third. I'm always right.
It's third down. 100%. Two receivers to the near side. Hand off to Barkin.
Oh, just a great job. And the coaching staff on the far side is loving their interior defensive lineman right there. 53-50. These guys are penetrating hard. Number 60 as well. They're not allowing anything to happen in that backfield.
No. 53, Enzo Fernandez. And number 50, Zachary Friend, who we've called his name a couple of times tonight. That's the penetration they needed.
Actually, I'm looking fourth down, but they're saying third down. They're giving them
another
down.
They're
going for it. Okay, well, you know what? There's
we'll
that famous
it.
Fifth down.
Yeah, it's spring.
There you go.
There we go.
The water break. I guess they got an extra down on the water break.
Third and about 18 here for the War Eagles of Titusville Astronaut.
And again, folks, we apologize. Our clock is we pushed it to start, and it just won't start. We'll get that fixed at halftime.
Rolling under 4 minutes as Gordon rolls to the near side. Gets across the 40. Tucks it. Hit at the 35. Claws his way forward to about the 31-yard line, so he's able to get about 8 yards.
What a great run by the quarterback right there, though. I mean, he got hit, spun around, and was still able to pick up 5 or 6 yards there, Bobby.
Yep.
Just great aggressiveness there. I mean, that was awesome right there. But he got it back to the original line of scrimmage now, and it sets up a more manageable fourth down coming up
here
for Astronaut.
And again, they've got their way deeper into Windermere territory. We can't say that Windermere has done the same to the Titusville defense, so credit the War Eagles. They've put together a substantial drive here to close out the first half of play. 3:07, clock rolls, second quarter. Two receivers to the near side for the War Eagles. Nathan Perrin nearest the sideline. Here's a throw over the top, and it goes in and out of the hands of the intended target, Colt Sturwald. He was wide open, should have hauled that in. Don't want that one back, and that'll be another four and out for Titusville Astronaut.
Had a man open, but that again, that's the spring. You learn, you know, your mistakes right there, what you need to do in the summer to get better, because that play will be there in the fall, and Astronaut will have a couple scores with that play for sure.
So Windermere will take over at their own 31-yard line. Outside of one fumble, it's been all four and outs and three punts here in the first half of play between these two schools. No score, 2:55 to play here in the first half. Again, our game tonight broadcast brought to you by Craig Martin Insurance and Financial Services, by State Farm, and also Gators Dockside of Central Florida. So much appreciate the support of high school academics and athletics.
Without a doubt. We wouldn't be here without them.
No, sir. Here we go. Windermere takes the field on offense again. Bryce Speed in at quarterback. He'll have trips to the near side. Speed with a pitch into the backfield. Good defensive read by Astronaut. Yet again, forces a 2-yard loss, and it'll be second and 12.
Yeah, I tell you what's really good about Astronaut's defense right now. Their ends penetrate to the point, Bobby, where they turn everything back into the center, and the rest of the Astronaut defense is sitting right there waiting for the running back to make his cutback, and when he does, he loses a yard or two.
100%. Couldn't agree more. They've got athletic defensive ends. In the middle, staying home, doing their job. Bertavian Edmondson as well, number 52, also down and dirty in the trenches there for Titusville Astronaut. Here's Bryce Speed yet again. Two receivers split each way. rolls to the near side, looking, fires, has a man. Catch made by Rozier. And he's going to get all the way out across the 45 to the 46-yard line. And that'll be a first down. But hold that thought. Penalty flag lays on the far side of the field, just
in the backfield.
In between,
back there.
Yeah, the 30 and the 25. I want to take a moment to let everybody know out there who's tuning in that the Varsity Sports Network's app is now available on Roku and Apple TV and also Fire Stick.
Yep.
This is a big development for the Varsity Sports Network. So if you have Roku, if you have Apple TV or a Google Chrome Fire Stick, download the Varsity Sports Network app. You can access 24/7 broadcasts or live streams as we are right now here from Titusville. So, Bobby, to you, congratulations for that. That's an excellent opportunity for this company to grow in an enormous fashion.
Well, congratulations to all of us. We've all worked hard to get to this point right here and, you know, to offer it in different platforms like we are with our OTT channels and to be able to still see it on your phone or on your computer, anywhere you wanted to go to, anywhere around the world. That's something that we've always dreamed about, and here it is. To be a part of Roku, to be a part of Amazon Fire and Apple TV, that's just added gravy on the, you know, icing on the cake, basically.
Yep.
So we're very excited. This is our spring as well, because you can see we've come a long way from our broadcast from before, and we're very excited where we are right now.
Yeah, I get to implement some new things into the broadcast as a miscommunication on the snap. Bryce Speed able to fall on it. Loses about 2, maybe 3 yards. And those are the little things you see in games like this. Again, it's extraordinarily early.
Another penalty on the play right there.
Yep.
That'll move him back even further.
Sure will. Well, that's going to be second and about 22. They've got to get all the way out to the 41-yard line for the first down. A lot of pressure here with a minute 22 to play in the first half. Clock rolls as whistles blow now. Officials are going to have a little discussion.
Yep.
And both teams look like they're making their way to the sideline to get a quick water break. And not sure how long he'll keep them on the sideline.
Was there a timeout called? Or?
No, sir.
I'm not sure what's going on.
Not either. But we'll keep it here. No score from Astronaut High School here in Titusville, Florida on the Varsity Sports Network. I'm Bobby Allen along with Bobby Latmore. And I want to give a shout-out to our sideline reporter, Madison Little. Another great addition to the broadcast, a recent graduate of University of Central Florida's broadcast program.
Yeah, we caught Madison on a couple Fox Network presentations and a couple of other local UCF games, and she was very good, interested in being a part of continuing her career after she graduated, so we brought her along.
I think
it's
a great
opportunity. And she's done fantastic, so we're very excited to have Madison a part of our network.
Both teams make their way back out on the field. It'll be second and about 21, 22 yards with a minute 27 to play here in the first half. Bryce Speed in the shotgun. Ochoa in the backfield. Two receivers split each way for the quarterback, Mr. Bryce Speed. Here's the snap. Speed looking. Floats one over the top. Ochoa collects it in the middle of the field. Bobbles it, but does have the presence of mind to grab it. Gets out across the 25 to about the 26, where he is going to be dropped, gain of about 6 yards.
Bobby, that pass gets to Ochoa quicker instead of floating like it did.
Well,
there's yardage on that. He had a wall and a escort
going
towards him. So, Astronaut, go ahead and take a timeout right here.
Timeout, Astronaut. We'll take a break with him. No score. 58 seconds to play in the first half. We'll be back in a moment right here on the Varsity Sports Network.
We're often asked, what's more important in retirement? Having a great plan or working with a great advisor? The answer is that both are vitally important to your retirement success. Retirement planning is not just a one and done. Even the best plans will need to be adjusted. That's exactly why you need an experienced partner to guide you on your journey. How confident are you? Call us today for a second opinion.
Welcome back into the Varsity Sports Network as you get a close-up view of the Titusville Astronaut Huddle as they get their instructions from head coach Justin Warden here on their home field. J. Donnelly Field here in Titusville. Minute 10 to play here in the first half. No score. The visiting Windermere Wolverines have the football. It'll be third down and about 15. Line of scrimmage is roughly the 26-27-yard line of Windermere. Bryce Speed in at quarterback. Andres Ochoa in the backfield for the Wolverines. Single receiver to the near side. Trips in a bunch formation top of the screen. See if they convert here. Here's the snap. Handoff comes to Ochoa, and he is met. No, excuse me, that was not Ochoa. That was Uloa.
Yeah.
Tavio Uloa on the handoff. He's met. Another good defensive play by Astronaut. They've been impressive.
Another timeout called quickly by Astronaut as well.
Minute one to play in the first half. Timeout again from Astronaut. We'll take a break with him. Back in a moment on the Varsity Sports Network.
Fourth down situation for Windermere.
And welcome back into the Varsity Sports Network here in this gorgeous Friday evening in Titusville, Florida. There's a look at the Windermere Wolverine huddle. No score here in this ball game between Windermere and Titusville Astronaut High School. Bobby Allen, Bobby Latmore, along with Madison Little, we appreciate you tuning in here on your home for high school sports in Florida. This is the Varsity Sports Network. And Windermere is going to punt this one away. Punts are not live here in spring game. No score yet. Not a lot going on offensively. Credit both defenses for keeping this game a shutout both ways. And after the punt, with 55 seconds to play in the first half, Astronaut will have the football first and 10 at about the 44-yard line. They will be on the Windermere. Looks like, yeah, they're going to spot him about the 44.
So now, still good field position. Great. Less than a minute left to go. No score on the scoreboard. We saw their field goal kicker a little suspect. You know, yeah. Young kid.
Yes.
Here for Astronaut, but you know, give him an opportunity here in the spring. See what he can do.
Absolutely, he's a freshman. You know, you got to give it time.
Work in progress, baby. You got to love it.
Yeah, Titusville Academy has started the last three drives in Windermere territory. Shows you just how well, their defensive performance.
Titusville Academy. You're at the other game over there.
Astronaut, I was, right?
You were at the other field.
Here's Gordon. Smart decision to go to the man underneath. Pass is caught by Jordan Marquez. He's going to be wrapped up after a gain of about three, maybe four.
That's a big man.
You are kidding.
Marquez is a big man. Coming out of that backfield, that little bowling ball right there just took three or four Windermere defensive players for about 3 yards.
What about the performance last night at Nathaniel Hall?
Unreal. Unreal.
Just having his way.
Did he already make his name? He's already in the stat sheet of every defense in Orange County.
No doubt. Timber Creek's Nathaniel Hall. Four touchdowns, 174 yards unofficially. And he did it all in virtually the first half. Here's Gordon rolling to the near side. Throws at the last moment. Catch made on the near side. Good throw, good catch. Nathan Perrin with the grab on the near side. And he has enough for the first down as he gets down to the 30.
So what do you do right here? Seven seconds left on the clock. Yep. You're way far out. You're just going to have to just throw it up.
Yeah, I think so. I don't think we're going to see a 50-yard attempt for a field goal as we did last night.
Right?
It didn't end well. But you have to respect the effort in trying to line up and take it.
Yep, without a doubt. So 7 seconds left again, yep. Folks. We'll get our clock fixed here at halftime, but we're trying to stop it and start it when we need to. And
yeah,
it's just coming up with numbers that it wants to do. But we'll get it fixed.
Here's Gordon in the shotgun. Johnson comes in motion from left to right. Zarm in the backfield. Gordon looking to throw. Pressure comes, and he is going to be met and dropped by number 53, Enzo Fernandez from Windermere, and that'll take us to halftime. No score. in this spring game here from Titusville Astronaut High School between the Wolverines of Windermere and the War Eagles of Astronaut. Let's go.
We'll let Maddie get her
here
set
she's
up.
Running.
Yep, she's running right
yep.
now. We'll get her a little bit. You can see her right there running. I don't know why Joey's talking to her right now, but.
Yeah. So, Bobby.
Yes.
First half. I think my takeaway is Astronaut's defense. The way they started the game, really giving up some yardage to Ochoa.
Yep.
Boy, they buttoned that up quick.
They did. You know, they like you said, Joey, they don't know. They've never seen Windermere before. This is the first time these two teams have played. And for them to see what kind of offense they came out in, great adjustments made by all of them, I think that was really good. So you can see right now Madison's getting set up.
Yep.
And they're trying to get out of the sun right now, and we'll go with that right there. So let's take it down to Madison.
Sorry.
Am I looking at him or am I looking at you?
Just pretend he's not there. All right, Coach. So we have a score of nothing right now, but tell me, what are you seeing from this team tonight that you like?
They're fighting. You know, I told them that we're going to come out and play physical, execute on offense. I mean, we've had some self-inflicted wounds on offense, but defensively we're playing well. We're having fun. We're playing aggressive. So, you know, I'm happy.
And this is your first time in an actual game setting with this team. Yes, what are you learning tonight?
I mean, a lot. You know, it's just good. Honestly, it's just good to evaluate the kids, man. I mean, they're having a good time. It's been a great 2 weeks of practice. And, I mean, honestly, I'm just thankful, humbled, you know, blessed, really.
And what's going to be the conversation in the locker room to hopefully get some points on that board?
I'll just keep doing what we're doing. You know, we drove the ball two or three times. We just, you know, we dropped a couple of snaps. So just a little things, you know, just keep working. But, again, it's a blessing, man. Glory to God, and I'm just thankful. You know, I'm just happy to be here.
Guys, that was Windermere's head coach, Ricky Smith. Thank you so much.
Appreciate it. Take care.
Statewide coverage from the Panhandle to Central Florida to Broward and Miami-Dade down to the Keys. All 22 sports. From football, girls and boys basketball, softball, soccer, lacrosse, baseball, even swimming and track. Shows and live streaming broadcasts on various spectrums. Roku, Apple TV, Fire Stick, and on demand. 24/7, 7 days a week, only on BSN.
Great targets for quarterback Bryce Speed. We saw a great deal of Ochoa doing a lot of work in the first quarter. He's kind of been quiet the last few drives for Windermere. I'm sure they're going to want to get him going again. Single receiver split each way this time for the Wolverines. Speed goes under center. Here's the man, Ochoa, and this time he's going to be met and dropped. Great defense by Vondre Washington.
One thing I'm noticing about this Windermere offense, Bobby, is that, you know, Ochoa's back there waiting for the ball to come to him. He's not attacking the line, and that gives that Astronaut defense a time to penetrate and get back there and get Ochoa before he gets started. If they get him going towards that line of scrimmage full speed and he hits that hole at the right time at the handoff,
yep,
you can't stop him. And that's what happened the first couple plays, and that's why we noticed Ochoa early on, because he was doing that. Right now, it's a lot of hesitation in the backfield.
Listen, they say football is a game of inches. Well, I'll tell you what else it is. It's a game of half seconds.
Yes. And that one half second for Ochoa can make a difference.
Absolutely right. Great point. That'll bring up third and about four. Speed drops back in the shotgun again. Single receiver split each way. Now Rozier comes in motion. Speed fakes the throw, now takes off upfield, and he's going to be hit and met. But he is going to have enough for the first down as he makes his way out across the 20 to about the 25-yard line. That'll move the chains for the Wolverines of Windermere.
That play was broken from the beginning. I'm not sure what they were trying to do in that play right there. It almost looked like a quarterback sweep. Everybody was just, student body left. And then Speed says, that doesn't look good over here, because Astronaut did a great job. We talked about it earlier on how they get down to their ends, get good penetration and turn everything back in. Well, they did, but Speed had enough athleticism to break a couple tackles and get that first down. But a nice job by Astronaut right there to keep things going.
You know, listen, all things considered, they did what they had to do to prevent a first down. Speed, like you said, just used his athleticism and got the job done. Single receiver each way again. Ochoa in the backfield for quarterback Bryce Speed. He's going to fire it to the far side, and it's going to be bobbled and drops incomplete. Jonathan Porter, the target.
One little Astronaut defensive player just squeaked away with a late hit right there because
yes.
the receiver was coming up and he tackled him again. So interesting that luckily he did not get the call.
I believe that was Evan Callahan. Don't quote me on that.
Yeah, Callahan came in. That was Evan Callahan. But, you know, that's just being aggressive.
Yeah.
He didn't know whether or not the ball was still in the player's hands.
That's
but
right.
You got to be careful in certain situations like that, especially here when these new referees are starting to be trained, especially coming in the fall. That could really hurt you if you...
3:26
in the regular season.
Here in the third period, no score from Astronaut High School. Here's Speed again, fires over the middle. Has a man catch made for a gain of about 4 yards, but good wrap-up defense by Astronaut yet again. Catch made by number 12, Chris Maurice. Another one of those athletes you can put in many different positions for Windermere. And Vondre Washington will slowly make his way with a little limp off to the near sideline. Hopefully he's okay. He's one of the big-time defensive players for this Astronaut squad.
That's one thing you really got to be careful of here, too, in the spring as well. There's a clock stoppage here, and we're not sure why. Oh, we had a penalty on the play.
Sure did, and I didn't see a flag at all.
I didn't see a flag either, so they're going to move Windermere back. Wow.
It'll be a 5-yarder.
And we were sitting here just thinking that the Astronaut should have got a 15-yarder.
Yeah, I know,
but Windermere
right?
got the worst of it with another 5-yard penalty. It looked like an illegal shift. I really wasn't sure.
I bet you it was an illegal substitution because after we saw Evan Callahan come off after that potential late hit, we saw Dawson Main try to check in late, and he didn't get back in time. Bryce Speed in the shotgun for Windermere. Single man in the backfield will be Ochoa. Fakes the handoff. Looks to the near side as the pressure comes. Gets away from it. Still on his feet. Back across the 20. Now at the 30. Turns the corner. And he's going to be dragged. Wrapped up from behind. But not before. He has the first down.
First down for Windermere.
What a play right there by Speed, man.
That was unreal.
Well, he had everybody going close to the near side over here with the sweep, and then when Astronaut kind of overcommitted to that, he was able to get back around the backside back there and make the turn, make that corner, and able to get up. I'm surprised. Well, he did grab his shirt. He didn't grab the shoulder pads, so it was a legal tackle, but great job right there by the quarterback from Windermere.
Yeah, they all but had him wrapped up in the backfield. They got pressure the way they wanted to, but he just used his God-given ability to get out of trouble. Single receiver each way for Windermere. Polk lines up on the near side. Ochoa in the backfield. Polk comes in motion. He'll get the fake draw play to Polk. Polk. The Speed will keep it. No gain.
Yeah, Polk, I don't think, understood the play right there. He went up the speed and stopped. That should have been a jet sweep where he keeps coming. You can see Coach Smith on the far side. Hey, you got to keep coming, man.
Yep.
So that's going to be a tough deal right there for them. You know, no gain on the play, but that's something right there where they'll work on definitely in the summertime.
Yep, absolutely. So it'll be second and 10. Speed trotted over to the sideline to get the call. Now he'll set the offense for Windermere. 2:05 to play. Clock rolls, third quarter. No score between the Windermere Wolverines with the football and the homestanding Titusville Astronaut High School War Eagles. Speed with the receiver set each way. Spins it, looks to the far side. Catch made. And out of bounds goes Porter. He is a wonderful target.
I tell you what, his size is unreal. Absolutely. This kid is already midseason form right now for Windermere, so it's a great job for him to get things rolling here because Speed, that's a great target for Speed.
Jonathan Porter, they call him JP. So I will definitely be keeping my eye on his stat sheet as the season progresses this fall. Same formation. Speed looks to the near side this time. Finds his man. Catch made by Polk. But great defense right there by number 4, Hunter's arm. Making the grab and bringing up fourth and about 3.
big fourth down right here, 3 yards to go. Windermere, you know, if they don't get this right here, interesting because you're inside your own territory right here. Ashton moved the ball the last time they had the ball, Bobby. So this is a big play right here for Coach Smith.
Yes, it is. Huge play, fourth and three. As Windermere huddles up at their own 40.
They better hurry up. They're going to get that five-yard delay of gain.
Yes, they will. Single receiver each way once more for Bryce Speed. He stands in the shotgun. Ochoa in the backfield.
And oh, my goodness. They knew right away that they were trying to draw him off. And
Colin Smith got bit.
A little bit of over-anxiousness right there, but that's a learning experience. Coach him up a little bit and make it happen.
Sure. That'll give Windermere a first down, move the chains. Line of scrimmage will be at midfield now. 45 seconds, clock rolls, third quarter, no score.
And he sat there and kept jumping, and they finally got him across. You know, that's one thing where, you know, you just stop. Don't try.
Don't do anything.
Just go back to what you were doing.
Go. No.
Yeah, right? Yeah. Sometimes you wish you were a coach that had one of those little strings that you shoot and you tug him back.
Yep. Same formation once more for the Wolverines of Windermere. Speed. It's the snap. Looking downfield. He's going to throw over the top. Has a man. It's Polk. Is he open? Yep. But the ball is knocked away. Great defense by Barkin. To break up the pass, Polk had a step on his man. If the throw had just been a touch farther, it might have been the first score of the game.
You know what, though, Bobby? I'm just going to say this.
Great defense,
what a great throw.
Yeah.
That's a situation right there where Polk's got to go up and get the ball. He's got to fight for that. Yes. He's got to fight for that ball, and he's got to go up and get it right there.
Yeah, big credit downfield. Anthony Terry, Hunter's arm. Barkin. Those defensive backs did very well. Eight seconds. Almost to the end of the third period, no score. Second down. Here's Speed. Fires as he's hit. Porter goes up and grabs it out of the air, pulls it down in War Eagle territory.
Did they stop the clock with 1 second?
They did.
Porter is complete.
Nope. Well.
Brought down by Anthony Terry.
They're going to run it.
Yeah, they're going to run it out. That'll be the end of the third period. No score here from Astronaut High School. Let's take it down to the sideline at our own Madison Little.
Of tonight's game, and we still have no score. I talked about it. The coach talked about it. Tonight is all about figuring it out for these teams. Both teams have had decent drives, but unable to reach the end zone because, like you guys said earlier, this game is all defense. Let's see if that changes here in the fourth quarter. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Madison. We appreciate all of her reporting. What a great addition to the broadcasts, having somebody down right near the action. We'll take a quick break before we come back for the fourth and final quarter. Back in just one moment, right here on the Varsity Sports Network.
This sportsmanship goes beyond the court. It starts with respect. Respect the game. The Orlando Magic are proud to support this season of middle school basketball. For more information on Orlando Magic Youth initiatives, visit OrlandoMagicYouth.com.
And welcome back into the Varsity Sports Network here from Titusville Astronaut High School in Titusville, Florida. I'm Bobby Allen along with Bobby Latmore and Madison Little. We appreciate you tuning in as we are ready for the fourth and final quarter here of this spring game as the visiting Wolverines of Windermere High School take over. They will have it first and 10 just inside War Eagle territory at about the 47-yard line. It'll be third. Here's Speed, fires over the top. Porter turned around, not looking, and it's going to be picked off. streaking up the far sideline for the War Eagles. Ball comes out the end of the play. Scrum for it. And now some extracurricular activity right here on the near side of the field.
Yep, that was where Speed was getting rushed, and he got a lot of pressure on him, and he just threw it up, and there was Porter in the backfield, in the defensive backfield. Also quarterbacking tonight, able to come up with a nice interception right there, drive it inside Windermere territory, and after the fumble, there was a fumble on the play, and one person recovered it. What a great job right there by Windermere to hold it. But there's two more flags here, Bobby. They may be against Astronaut here, but then there's also another one on the far side for the late hit. So interesting.
Two of them over there, too.
Yep.
Four
flags. Let's see what happens coming up right here. There's a lot of laundry on the field tonight.
There is. You know, of course, not being right there by the action, I don't know how much space there was between the football and number 15, Jonathan Porter for Windermere, but it almost seemed like he kind of gave up on the play.
A little bit,
yes. It was a clean
interception.
Yes. No trouble. I mean, there was no fighting for it. He just picked it right out of the air.
I'll be honest with you. I don't even think he saw it.
That's what I'm saying.
He turned around, and the ball was already thrown behind him, and there was really nothing he really could do on that right there. But, you know, you got to make an effort for it, you know, just try to. But here's the thing. Yep. Speed was rushed.
Sure.
Astronaut was all in his face when he threw the ball. He didn't get anything on it, threw off his back foot. So great job defensively there for the War Eagles.
Great pressure on Bryce Speed, hit as he threw it. And Vondre Washington, number 56 for Astronaut, was in on the scrum on the far side of the field. He is limping again, and he's going to make his way off to the near sideline again. It's going to be a personal foul against Astronaut. Personal foul now against Windermere.
Well,
he
signaled two personal fouls against Windermere, one against Astronaut.
Okay.
Are they going to mark off the two and just give Windermere the 15 yards here? Because if that's exactly what he said right here, interesting on what they said.
So
the referee on the far side is asking the same thing I am. He just said, you called two on Windermere and one on Astronaut. What are we doing here?
Now, maybe it looks like we're going to get some clarification.
All right, so dead ball, personal foul against Windermere. That's it.
Okay.
So they wiped off the
first two,
and they're just going to go ahead and give the 15 yards to Windermere. So, or to Astronaut against Windermere. Big play right here, Bobby. That moves Astronaut into Windermere territory again. So Windermere now with their backs up against the wall again for
that defense.
They've got to stand up. Oh, now they're going again. Whoa.
Now that's interesting.
That's interesting right
there.
Spot? Yes.
That was 15 from the spot. That's going to move the line of scrimmage down to the 11.
Now they're going to come back. See, that's what they did. They walked it all off. So basically it's where everything happened before. So that right now you stop, that's where you were.
Yeah.
So there we go.
There we go. Yeah, that was right.
So basically it's a 15. We had it right.
We did.
Yard. But legally they have to do it.
That's
so
true.
I guess that was true. But nice
I think
job.
That's a rule they could do away with.
Give it up to the refs, man.
You
know what?
They
were right on this one right here. They did what that. We called it up here, which we thought, and they of course they listened to us.
No, absolutely.
That's why they're great referees.
Yeah, nobody knows we had a mic'd in. They don't know.
Yeah, right? They don't know that.
No. You got to keep that on the down low.
It's a good crew tonight. They have kept this game moving forward and a great job.
So here we go. War Eagles with an interception. With the football, Zarm with the handoff, got some room, gets across the 15, still on his feet. Did the ball come out? Don't think it did. And he's going to get it all the way down to the 10-yard line. Another first down for Astronaut.
What a run by that young man. Was their effort and intensity in that run aggressive the way he was? He put his feet and did not stop until he got inside that 10-yard line, man. I'm telling
you, tough.
That was awesome. Who's getting the ball right here?
I think you got to go to Zarm. I think so. You got single receiver on the near side. Low snap again. Zarm does get the handoff, takes it to the near side, churning his legs. Look at the freshman go down to the 6-yard line. Boy, he's a tough kid.
Yeah, he is.
My goodness. That'll bring up second.
I'm not sure. Yeah, they're right at the 10, so it's goal to goal right now. Yep.
Yep, second and goal from the 6. They're going to line up a single receiver to the near side once more. That'll be Nathan Parent. Now they're going to put barking in the backfield.
I'd give it to the big man. He's kind of come across this left side and go. Nope. Bad snap again. And what a tough break.
Wow.
All you've been calling it, Bobby, yes, all game long, they have been flirting with that two-hop snap coming back. And that time it hurt him.
It's only a matter of time before it bites him, and that time it did. And good job by number 53, Enzo Fernandez from Windermere, to be there and bring Gordon down once he picked the ball up off the ground.
Now a very difficult play right here, but you know what? They'll be in this in the fall. This is how you learn.
Sure.
And they make it. You know, you make a mistake. You know, learn from adversity right now. How are you going to get back up?
You have to have a short-term memory. That's something that is preached so often. Here's a handoff. Barkin bounces to the outside. Tries to get the corner. Can he get to the end zone? He's dripped up at the goal line. Touchdown, Astronaut.
How about that play right there? He was dragged at the five, still turned his legs, and went right on in. A great job.
12-yard touchdown by number one, Nigel Barkin.
Did you see this coming tonight?
I did not. Honestly, I really wasn't sure what to expect, but considering a 8A, 4A matchup, you kind of, you know, instinctively on paper want to give the edge to the 8A team. But, man, hats off to the War Eagles.
What a great run right there. You know, they had it at the beginning of the second half on a great opening drive, Bobby. They found a little bit of a crease with that running game, and right now they finished it up right here with a great run inside. And I'll tell you what, Vaughn, your man Zarn, has been phenomenal tough tonight. That's kind of our guy last night, Hull.
Absolutely, and that 1-2 punch I think is going to be very good as that season progresses between Zarm and Barkin.
No doubt about it. Zarm very, very – he got him down there. Barkin closed it up.
Extra point is going to be very low, but it does go through the uprights. Our score.
Man, Astronaut, that was a shotgun.
Right? Astronaut 7, Windermere 0. 9:47 to play in the game. Back in a moment right here on the Varsity Sports Network.
That was awesome.
Welcome back in to the Varsity Sports Network. As you see, the band from Astronaut High School and the students cheering after Nigel Barkin hits Pater finally. First touchdown of the ball game for either team, a 12-yard TD from number one, the current sophomore rising junior. Extra point was good, and Astronaut leads Windermere 7-0. I'm Bobby Allen along with Bobby Latmore and also Madison Little, as we finally have a little life in the crowd on this side of the facility here at J. Donnelly Field here in Titusville, Florida. And that 1-2 combination, you had Hunter's arm getting Astronaut, getting the War Eagles down close, and Barkin doing the rest. After a little of adversity, they got pushed back there on second down, making a long third.
Well, it all started with Gordon's interception, and the way he was able to take it and then bring it back down the field gave Astronaut great field position. And, of course, Windermere helped him out with their penalty.
Sure.
Moved them even further down there. But, again, you said it, Zarm, with just phenomenal running for that young man tonight, and just really just absolutely put everybody on his back and says, I'm going to take you home, and he did.
He really did. Windermere will start at their own 25-yard line, first and 10. We'll see if they can answer. Their last possession ended in an interception on the pass attempt from Bryce Speed downfield to Jonathan Porter that was intercepted by Astronaut quarterback Gordon. So Ryan Gordon getting it done on both sides of the football tonight.
Let's see how Windermere responds to this. You know, they've been trying to get their offense in sync all night long, and now with a little bit of adversity down a little bit, let's see what they're going to be able to do. So now they're just throwing the football back. That I think Astronaut took the football from Windermere, and they're trying to get Windermere's football back. So the officials. Yep, we just started playing like, if this is going to happen, we need to start playing like the NFL.
Yeah,
they have one ball the whole time.
One ball, be done with it.
Yep.
Absolutely. One of the officials on the near side was over behind the team. He has now made his way back over onto the field.
So now they're trying to figure out where the football is. Now they got one. Do they have one? Yeah, there's a ball on the field.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
So
what
now they're all. I don't know what's going on here. So holding up the game here a little bit, but trying to get it right.
Yeah. Hey, they've done an excellent job tonight. We've complimented them several times, and it looks like they are now ready. So Bryce Speed will stand in the shotgun. Single man to the backfield. Two receivers to the near side.
He stole my football.
No, give me back. No, it's not mine.
Give me the ball.
Football.
I'm going home.
I'm going home.
Give me the ball. I'm going home. We're still waiting.
Still
what do we
waiting.
Got going on?
I'm not sure. Ochoa lines up in the backfield as they await the start of this drive, and now we're going to play some football.
Maybe there was some gum stuck on him or something. Who
maybe.
Knows?
Here's Speed, quick hitter to the outside, far side, catch is made, and it's going to be a turnover.
Oh, Hutch fumble. Look at how big that is.
Wow. Astronaut takes over.
Holy cow. How about that right there?
That's
look at a freshman jumping up and down over there. He might have got the fumble recovery. Look at him.
Wow. You got to love that. So Astronaut with a gift, and they will have outstanding field position.
I was just about to say, what? Look at the speed Astronaut's still showing on defense, and they come out with the, I'm telling you what, you cannot take a playoff against this Astronaut defense.
No, you can't.
They look great.
They forced two turnovers here in the second half, and with 9:41 to play, they've got great field position. Here's Zarn coming to the near side.
Another low snap, Bobby.
Yeah, that's an issue they're going to have to work
yes,
on.
Yes, sir.
As Zarm's able to gain a yard on the play.
It's going to be second down.
Second and nine. But I listen, you know, really, Astronauts only had one, you know, bad mistake off the low snap.
Right.
So a lot of credit has to go to Ryan Gordon for being able to, you know, as you said, play second baseman and shortstop right there to collect those footballs that are so low.
And dish them out.
Yeah. And still have the arm speed to get them out. And here we go. Single receiver, top of the screen. A couple of players in the backfield. His arm gets the handoff, cuts it back up the middle. Fights his way for the first down and more all the way down to the 11-yard line.
What a run right there. I thought he was going to run him kid over.
He hit him.
Still he was, going. He was still backed up.
He was looking for that. He was looking for the contact.
Again, right at the 10-yard line. First and goal from the 10.
Very impressive.
Here.
Looks like Astronaut is going to set up in the same formation here. They'll have Zarm in the backfield. Also back there is Colt Sturwald.
There's another errant snap.
And this one, luckily, the speed of Ryan Gordon is able to get back there and jump on the football. They'll lose yardage back across the 15 to the 16. Something's going on there between center and quarterback. Tristan Day at center here for Astronaut this evening. But again, like you said, it's spring. That's something they can work on. That's only the second negative play they've had off those bad snaps. So that's a good thing. Zarm with the carry again. Tries to fight his way back into the middle. Gets a few yards back, down to about the 12, 13-yard line. 7:40 to play. Clock rolls. 7:25 to play. Barkin's going to check in. Nope. Yep, he is going to make his way into the game now. Zarm's going to get a breather. Well-deserved. Hard to believe Hunter Zarm, current freshman, rising sophomore. And as you mentioned, Bobby, if he wasn't known, he will be.
Yep.
Based on what we've seen tonight.
He's got a book on him now.
Yeah. Here's a handoff. Barkin cuts in to the middle of the field. Gets across the 10 down to the 9. Maybe the 8, and that'll be fourth down and goal from the 8-yard line. For Astronaut, they lead it 7-0 thanks to the 12-yard touchdown run by Nigel Barkin on their last possession.
Give him an extra point. Got his feet wet a little bit. Now let's see what you're going to do with a field goal.
Yeah.
Good move here by coach.
I love it. Situational practice.
Absolutely.
Yep.
And it's almost a little bit longer than a field goal, but this is giving him a good 25-yard field goal attempt coming up right here, and it's just good confidence going into the summer.
Here we go. Ashton Alberts with the kick. It is up, and it is good. Field goal good. Our score, Astronaut 10, Windermere 0, 5:59 to play the game. Back in a moment right here on the Varsity Sports Network. Welcome back into the Varsity Sports Network. Our game tonight brought to you by Craig Martin Insurance and Financial Services by State Farm. Call them today, 407-656-1040. 5:59 to play here in the fourth quarter. Titusville Astronaut having a heck of a fourth quarter. Scored on a 12-yard touchdown run by Nigel Barkin to make it 7-0, and then that has been followed by a fumble recovery and a 25-yard field goal for Ashton Alberts to make it 10-0. Here's the kickoff. Windermere will have it first and 10 to start this possession here in the second half. I'm Bobby Allen along with Bobby Latmore and on the sideline, Madison Little. We appreciate everybody tuning in. We also want to thank Gators Dockside, Bar and Grill of Central Florida. Everybody specifically tuning in tonight at the Gators Dockside in Windermere. And we also want to let everybody know that Varsity Sports Network now has apps available on Roku, Apple TV, and Fire Stick. So be sure to go search for Varsity Sports Network. You can watch the 24/7 channel or live broadcasts from across the state of Florida. So big things on the horizon for the Varsity Sports Network.
Yeah, we're really looking forward to it. We got a big announcement. We had one a couple of weeks ago where we're actually doing, we did it last year, Bobby. You were a part of it. We did high school football media days here in Orlando. We did one also in the Daytona region for our Daytona channel. Well, everybody around the state heard about it, wanted to be a part of it. So we have 16 media days coming up. Starting in July, we end up the second week of August, right before the high school football season starts. And we're going to also host a two-hour high school football premiere right before the season starts that week on August 16th. So, folks, get ready.
Yes.
If you want to know anything about high school football, you tuned right into the right spot here on Varsity Sports Network.
Here come the Wolverines. Bryce Speed fires one on an inside route to the far side. And they will get out across the 30 to close to the 31-yard line.
That right play right there is very dangerous. You had a receiver coming inside with about four or five linebackers that he was looking at when he caught it. Usually that's a wide receiver screen where you got some running, some linemen in front of him, but he didn't have any help at all, so he made a good play.
Tyler Maggio with the catch. Second and a manageable five. Two receivers split each way. Daddy Yoloa goes and has a word with Bryce Speed. Now back to his position in the slot.
Am I supposed to go right or left?
Here's Speed rolling to the near side. Tucks it across the 30. 35-40 flag is thrown to the backfield as he does get pushed out of bounds just shy of the 45-yard line. But we'll check the laundry. It's in the vicinity of
holding again.
Against yep. Windermere. That'll be a costly penalty, negating a first down run.
You know, I hope they didn't call it on Ochoa, the running back, because he had a beautiful block on the blitz.
He
did call a holding call. Hurts them on this play, unfortunately. But I want to mention Ochoa right there.
Yeah.
He came in. He had the blitz picked up and allowed Speed to get outside. If he doesn't block him, Speed's in for a sack. But
sure.
Give a credit where credit's due right there. Nice block by the running back.
It's a tough kid, Ochoa. Andres Ochoa. He can do it on both sides of the football. Primary running back. And also, as you just saw a while back, good on defense as well. So that moves the Wolverines of Windermere High School back to the 20-yard line, where it'll be second and 15. Windermere,
tough break.
A newer school. This is their fourth season of varsity football. So they're still building a program as well. Windermere Prep has been around for a while. So here we go. Bryce Speed, he'll have trips to his right.
And they're still building another school over there because of the number of people in that area.
Speed throws it over the top, and it's going to be just overthrown as he looked downfield for his intended target, Tyler Maggio. Yeah, that's crazy how they're opening schools left and right. Last night we had the Lake Nona game. They are now, according to our friend Doug Patterson with the FHSAA, Orange County Athletic Director.
Yep.
Lake Nona is now the most populated high school in
Orange County.
In Orange County.
Yep.
And he was telling me about the plans to build that new school down around Lake Nona to alleviate that pressure. It's just amazing.
The growth in this area, especially with new Universal now building a new theme park over where they're building it off John Young Parkway over there, is adding to that area tremendously. So it's just exploding here in Central Florida. So a lot of interesting things coming up. We had
there
two
really
new high schools last year open up, Lake Buena Vista and Horizon.
Yep.
More to come definitely here in Orange County in the next few years.
Here's Speed, rolls to the far side, fires on the run, has a man over the top, and it's going to be in and out of the hands of his intended target, incomplete. You got to get that one.
Yep, you do have to get that one, Bobby.
Wow.
You said it yourself, but again, a learning experience right here. This is something right here that they'll learn over the summer.
Sure.
They'll get their timing down. They'll get everything down, what's expected for them, and, you know, this is where you got to coach them up right now.
Absolutely, you do. Hey, give a lot of credit to Bryce Speed. That was a tough throw on the run.
Beautiful throw.
Yes.
Beautiful throw. Good point, Bobby. That was absolutely a perfect throw.
It really was.
Into the hands of his receiver, and unfortunately couldn't make the catch, but still, good. You know what? Take a positive out of that, and it was a great job by the quarterback.
That was Lee Polk as the intended target, and that'll bring up fourth down and a punt. So now, Titusville Astronaut will have decent field position with 4:51 to play in the contest. They'll have it first and 10 at their own 46-yard line. So let's see if they can follow up with three scoring drives in a row. It started on a 12-yard touchdown run by Nigel Barkin three possessions ago. Their last time with the football, it resulted in a 25-yard field goal by Ashton Alberts. And then now here they'll start at their own 46.
Well, that was an easy recap.
That was it. Yep.
That was an easy recap.
So far in the game.
Last night we had, what, 62 points?
Yep.
Tonight we have 10.
10.
Yes. That's high school football. That's what you got to love about it. One thing, tonight, and we know, I'm going to say it right now, fourth quarter, Bobby, they're still got their first squads out there.
We saw that last night.
Here's another bad snap.
Wow,
working on it.
That's been a...
Oh, did Windermere get it?
It's close.
See what they've got. That's a tough play right there because a Windermere player came in and was fighting for it, but Gordon able to wrestle it away.
Give
so
credit
nice
to
job.
Ryan Gordon
yes.
right there.
That was a tough because number 29 from Windermere came flying in. I thought he got it.
Wow. I'm telling you. Here we go. Timeout Windermere. We'll take a break with him. 4:28 to play in the ballgame. 10-0 Astronaut on top. Back in a moment right here on the Varsity Sports Network.
Timeout Windermere.
We're often asked, what's more important in retirement, having a great plan or working with a great advisor? The answer is that both are vitally important to your retirement success. Retirement planning is not just a one and done. Even the best plans will need to be adjusted. That's exactly why you need an experienced partner to guide you on your journey. How confident are you? Call us today for a second opinion.
Good sportsmanship goes beyond the court. It starts with respect. Respect the game. The Orlando Magic are proud to support this season of middle school basketball. For more information on Orlando Magic Youth Initiatives, visit OrlandoMagicYouth.com.
We're coming back.
And we'll go back into the Varsity Sports Network. Here from Astronaut High School, Titusville, Florida, I'm Bobby Allen, along with Bobby Latmore and Madison Little down on the sideline. It's worth noting that Titusville Astronaut lost six kids to recruiting. They didn't have a kicker. The most versatile kid on the team is the quarterback, Ryan Gordon, also a standout baseball player, and he's only had 2 days of practice to come into this game. So that goes to show you right there the continuity is still building with these teams. It's early.
Without a doubt.
Yeah. That's interesting stuff. Here's Gordon as we speak of him. Tries to turn the corner, and he's going to get wrapped up and dropped for a loss on the play. Good defense there by Windermere on the chase down. That was Porter.
And they'll take another quick timeout.
They sure will. 4:18, that stops the clock. Fourth quarter, we'll take another one with them. Back in a moment, right here on the Varsity Sports Network. And we'll get back into the Varsity Sports Network. 4:18 to play in the fourth quarter. 10-0. Astronaut on top of Windermere. Let's go down to the sideline with Madison Little.
Guys, you might see number 22, Ryan Gordon, on both sides of the ball tonight. He's quarterback and also your kicker. I talked to Coach Warden's wife, Carrie Warden, and she was telling me that they lost a lot of kids to recruiting in the offseason, and so they had to fill in those gaps. And he was just one of the more versatile players, able to play on both sides of the ball and be really productive for this team. Guys?
Yeah, very interesting stuff. Thanks, Maddie. And it just goes to show you how valuable some kids are to athletic programs. And Ryan Gordon is no exception here for Astronaut High School. He'll stand in at the quarterback position. No wide receivers. And it's going to be a handoff to Hunter Zarm. Breaks out across the 25 to the 26-yard line. And that'll bring up fourth down. And it's going to be a punt from Titusville Astronaut as they had to get all the way into Wolverine territory to the 44-yard line for the first down. Tough sledding there.
Yep, Windermere is going to call their last timeout here of the half, too.
We'll take a break with them. Back with more right here on the Varsity Sports Network.
We're often asked, what's more important in retirement, having a great plan or working with a great advisor? The answer is that both are vitally important to your retirement success. Retirement planning is not just a one and done. Even the best plans will need to be adjusted. That's exactly why you need an experienced partner to guide you on your journey. How confident are you? Call us today for a second opinion.
And welcome back into the Varsity Sports Network. Once again, as you see the Titusville Astronaut marching band doing their job up in the stands here for the War Eagle faithful with 4:12 to play in the fourth, 10-0. War Eagles lead it. I'm Bobby Allen along with Bobby Lamore and Madison Little down on the sideline. Fourth and
a mile.
Half the state of Florida. And they're going to punt this one away. So Windermere will have another opportunity. As you just heard from Madison Little down on the sideline. Ryan Gordon, quarterback, kicker, also going to do punt duty here.
Just got finished with baseball.
Yeah, just 2 days of spring practice after finishing up baseball. Just an incredible athlete. I saw him cooking hot dogs earlier, filling the water bottles.
Wasn't he out here
beautiful
mowing the
punt? Look at here.
Wasn't he outside mowing the grass?
He's mowing before, when we were striping coming up? The
yeah,
field.
Striping the
way
field.
In.
Yeah, there you go. Yep.
Nice punt.
Beautiful
from
punt.
Ryan Gordon. And that's going to give Windermere the football all the way down inside the 30 to about the 28-yard line.
Tough with them right now. No timeouts left. And just seeing what Windermere can do right now. You got 4 minutes left in this game. And it's going to be interesting to see how their offense reacts to the pressure that they need. You know, they got to be determined. They got to get this thing going.
They really do. You know, time is not on their side, as you mentioned, and you know, you've got to start with credit from Astronaut really turning it on here in the fourth quarter. You know, I think I'm going to do a players of the game, and I'm going to give it to the Astronaut offensive line.
Good call, man.
Because their ability to control the line of scrimmage in the second half has led to this 10-0 lead, which I think has raised a lot of eyebrows. So hats off to them, and that's something huge to build on.
You take offense, I'll do defense tonight.
That's where
I'm
going
to give
me.
It back to the Astronaut defense. Yeah. Two huge turnovers here in the fourth quarter, which allowed all their points off the one interception by Gordon, bringing it down for the first touchdown, and then the fumble recovery in for the field goal.
Yep. There it is. That's how important all three phases of the game are. And this is a perfect example of it here tonight at Astronaut High School. Here's Bryce Speed for Windermere, rolls to the far side. Fires out in the flat, has a man, catch made. All the way out across the 35 to about the 37-yard line.
Short of the first down by a yard, but still, that's something positive. They got good first down yardage right there.
Absolutely. Tyler Maggio with the catch. And we hadn't seen Maggio in the entire first half. He didn't really become a target till this fourth quarter.
Right.
And I think there's a certain level of trust there between Bryce Speed and Tyler Maggio that we're starting to see. Trips to the near side. Single man in the backfield. Bad snap. Speed has to use his speed to get back and cover that football.
Man,
all the way back to the 21.
They had a couple of those as well.
Flag comes in late.
Yes, sir.
A little extracurricular in the middle of the field.
Something you got to contain your composure right now.
Yeah, that was Theo Fernandez from Windermere.
Yeah, just that, you know, he had little pancake action working, and he kept out nagging it, and he kept on him.
Yeah,
you know, and of course Astronauts chipper, you know, being chirping back at him, and of course he's frustrated enough as it is as well. So
sure,
they went ahead and gave him the penalty flag, which is unfortunate. Yeah, but this is a situation you got to keep your composure.
Absolutely.
In this situation right here, because now, instead of being third and whatever, now you're third and a mile, and you're the rest of the state of Florida on this side.
The
southern part. Yeah. The southern part of the state. You're over by one of the launch pads over there at Cape Canaveral.
Yeah. Going to Key West here.
Did they get the first down? They went back to third down. That is correct. So it's third and
A ton.
Yeah, it is.
It's almost 30 yards.
I don't think we can go that high.
No. Trips to the right side, handoff right at the middle, nothing there. No gain on the play. Good job by the Astronaut defensive line there.
As we come under 3 minutes here, Bobby, you know, looking at this team, you mentioned it earlier. The Astronauts are 4A school.
Yeah.
Windermere's an 8A school, and you know you don't like to make classifications, you know, as they are, but you got to give it up for Titusville here, man.
Absolutely.
I'm gonna tell you something.
Absolutely.
These kids over here in Astronaut, this is gonna be a fun team to watch this year. We have the Space Coast Channel coming live here on Varsity Sports Network here soon, and I'm gonna tell you something. If this is what the Space Coast has to offer, we're gonna have fun.
Absolutely, are.
We are gonna have a lot of fun here over here in Melbourne and Titusville, Cocoa Beach. I mean, man, this is going to be so much fun.
And then you take into consideration how young this team is. It's something to keep your eyes on, for sure.
You know, good point, Bobby. Just absolute, they're just so young. And now it's going to be fun to watch how they mature, especially now that they got a good spring under them and a successful spring. You know, you beat a pretty good dang team here, Windermere.
No.
Now you're going to go through the summer workouts knowing what you can do, know the possibilities, and coming out in the fall ready to be fired up, man. It's going to be interesting to see, you know, how they come out strong, because we're definitely going to be keeping an eye on them.
Absolutely. What a confidence booster. You said it. Now they're going to get it. First and 10 in really good position at the Windermere 30. Brian Gordon still in at quarterback. Single receiver set up to the near side. Couple of changes in the backfield. Gordon going to give the handoff. Coming to the near side at the 25 and down to about the 23-yard line will be Ranger Starkey, another sophomore. Flag lays at the 30 in the vicinity of holding. That was one of the names that Coach Warden mentioned as someone who he would like to see take on a greater role within this program, and that is number 25, who you just saw with the carry, Ranger Starkey. Great name.
Yeah, gotta love it, right?
Right.
So even though Ranger Starkey had a good run, that was negated by the penalty. So it's going to be first and 20 now coming up here for football. Now loose on the field. They'll go ahead and get that off, and then we'll be ready to play here.
Gordon still in the shotgun, single receiver near side. Starkey lines up in the backfield once again. He'll be joined also by Anthony Terry. Here's the snap, handoff coming near side. It's going to be Ranger Starkey again. He is hit, fights his way forward inside the 30. He took a hit there, kept on trucking, had some help from behind. And that's killing clock, too. Now down to a minute 20 and rolling here in the fourth quarter. Stick around for our post-game show coming up here in a bit.
Maddie's going to have some special guests down there with her here after the game. And, boy, she could pick a few of them, couldn't she?
She really
could. Astronaut team.
Really could. They should be tickled to death about the outcome of this game tonight as the crowd starts making a little noise here in Titusville.
And mention the crowd.
Yeah.
What a good crowd
awesome
here from Astronaut here on a Friday night in the spring. This is a great, great response to, you know, showing support for your team. What a good job Astronaut did tonight.
As you said, this Space Coast channel could be a lot of fun to watch this year. Here's a keeper by Gordon. He's going to get across the 20. Spins away from pressure. Still on his feet at the 15, down to the 10. What a run with 30 seconds to go by Ryan Gordon. That's going to set up. Should be first and goal from the 10 here in the waning moments of the fourth quarter as the hugs begin on the Astronaut sideline. The War Eagles turn it around in the second half. They put on a show, and they're going to walk away here in this spring game with a 10-0 victory over the Wolverines of Windermere. And again, as we said, an eyebrow raiser, 4A versus 8A, and the 4A school takes this one. 10-0, clock strike zero, and that'll be final. What a performance in the second half by the War Eagles.
Give it up for them, baby. They had a great game here tonight. They came out. First time that we've ever covered a Space Coast team over here, and they said, hey, Varsity Sports Network's coming over here. We're going to make something happen.
They want us to come back, I think.
Yeah, I think they do.
Both teams are going to line up on their respective sidelines and shake hands, and this one goes in the books. Final score, Titusville Astronaut 10, the visiting Wolverines of Windermere 0. We'll take a break. And back with more of the post-game show right here on the Varsity Sports Network.
One shot, not a future for sure. Let's go. Yeah, I was building on the lecture. Verses coming daily under pressure. Working on the plot and the scheme. The true star trademark is at the edge of your dreams. I'm talking one shot for the kill. The priest
got free. Yes, sir!
I'm turning dreams into reality. In the lab with the formula and chemistry. Your memories spark and motivate and make the industry shake. We put the balls in the plates. I'm talking one chance at best, yes. Painting pictures for the culture, keep the brushes fresh. Flip the flower, work the drum, a passion never rests. Freedom is our teacher, under pressure, now we bless. See how it's going, boys, where we go. It's one heart, one shot, now the future is yours. Go! Yeah. It's one hard word, shit, not a future of yours.
Good sportsmanship goes beyond the court. It starts with respect. Respect the game. The Orlando Magic are proud to support this season of middle school basketball. For more information on Orlando Magic youth initiatives, visit OrlandoMagicYouth.com.
We're often asked, what's more important in retirement, having a great plan or working with a great advisor? The answer is that both are vitally important to your retirement success. Retirement planning is not just a one and done. Even the best plans will need to be adjusted. That's exactly why you need an experienced partner to guide you on your journey. How confident are you? Call us today for a second opinion.
Welcome back into the Varsity Sports Network. We're going to go down to the sideline now and join Madison Little as she is standing by with the lone touchdown scorer of the evening, 9-1.
All right, guys, I'm here with Nigel Barkin. Nigel, you were the only player tonight to see the end zone. How proud of your team are you tonight?
Hey, I just want to say I'm proud of my team for blocking, man. We worked everything. We executed everything we worked, man. And we had a great night to get the job done.
And you are one of the players Coach pointed out to me before the game even started because of how you are, how able you are to contribute to this team. Why are you able to contribute so much?
Man, I love football. I love my teammates. I love my coach, and I love what I do. So I want to show them boys and play the game of football.
And how do you guys build on this win for your fall season?
Man, we're going to keep working in the summer. We're going to get right, and we're going to get ready for that for fall, for real.
All right, and I saw some of those dance moves on the field after you scored. Can you give me a little demonstration?
All right. Damn, boy, for real.
All right, back to you guys.
Yes, ma'am. All right.
Listen, that's the kind of sideline interviews you love.
Oh, my gosh. Is he a star tonight? I tell you what, he's going to love – Titusville loves him already. What a great young man. This is what high school football is all about. That's what the fun is. I love it, love it, love it. Congratulations, Nigel. That was awesome.
How lucky are we to be a part of that? Just an amazing performance in the second half, particularly by Titusville Astronaut. They score on a 12-yard touchdown run by Nigel Barkin, who you just heard from, and also a 25-yard field goal by Alberts. 10-0 final. And, you know, it's just impressive. And, again, we're so happy to have Craig Martin, Insurance and Financial Services by State Farm, as our game sponsor for tonight. We also want to thank the good folks at Gators Dockside in Central Florida. We are on live, and Gators Docksides will be throughout the fall season and these spring games, so we appreciate their both of those great companies for their participation in high school academics and athletics here in Central Florida.